Hey guys, this is Dr. Hub, your e-doctor. Today's topic is how to crack medical entrance exams. Everybody studies for 4 to 5 hours a day, but still only the cream layer is selected in the top institutes. The question is, are they normal, just like us, or are they extraordinary? The answer is that they are just like one of us, but have special study techniques and strategies for each and every chapter being studied. Now I'll be discussing a few points which will going to benefit you. First of all, champions, that is the people who get success in these exams, they don't C-cube. The C-cube stands for complain, crip and criticize. They instead follow D-cube, which stands for discipline, dedication and determination. The people who have discipline, dedication and determination, they will find success. And while choosing the best college, how do you find out if a college is good? Don't choose a college by the percentage of a student in the college, but by the number of people who are selected in the entrance exam. Knowing the selection ratio is more important. Higher the selection ratio, better is the college. Have contact with the right people. People who are genuine and who are humble and ready to share or teach you in difficult situations. So these people will help you in the long run. Keep in touch with the teaching staff, as they have years of experience with different types of students, and they also are always open to doubts being asked to them and will be happy to clear your doubts even if they are small. Keep track with your classmates who is doing better than you in the weekly or monthly tests. The person who is consistent throughout only will end up in a good college. The last minute miracles do not happen in entrance exams. Keep in touch with students who are already in a good medical college. They will share their problems and you can also share yours. This relieves the stress you face. Read only the NCERT first. You must have read the NCERT not once or twice, but a minimum of at least 50 to 60 times. You must be familiar with the minute details, such as numerical values and the other general knowledge questions present in the NCERT. In NEET, there are 3 levels of question: the easy one, medium, difficult. If you have an accuracy of more than 95% of the easy questions, then getting a seat is not difficult. Joining an online exam course will help you to understand where you stand in a bigger platform, and trust me, that only consistency from the very first test you take in 11th and to the last MCQ you take in 12th will determine your college. NCERT done, now what? Join a coaching center if it is necessary, because you will see like-minded people and will be easy to learn in such environment. NCERT done, now what? Joining a coaching center is necessary because you will see like-minded people and it will be easy for you to learn in such an environment. The group discussion, the MCQ test are a great plus point in cracking entrance exams. Get question bank and solve it 20 to 30 times so that you have it by hearted. Then slow down and understand the principles involved in each and every question. Rule of thumb is that getting all the easy questions right. How to get more marks? Chances of getting questions should be of the order easy, which is more easily solvable, than medium, than hard. Solving one hard question and leaving out 2 or 3 easy questions is not the plan to be followed. A person who gets all the easy questions right, they only check the number of questions that you attend. So it doesn't matter if it is easy or hard. Solving more number of easy questions will ultimately give you more marks. The blind rule. The blind rule. Enter the same option for the remaining question unanswered. It will give you a better edge over the others. Stay calm, be focused. Roam with good friend circle and keep in touch with the counselor for dealing with anxiety and depression, which is common for students taking entrance exam. Don't compare yourself with others. This will do more harm to yourself. Make sure you always remain above average in the exams conducted in the weekly or monthly basis. This will make sure you are always ahead of most of the others. Don't start preparation in the last moment because the above average would have already completed the layer of easy and medium questions and will be looking forward to solve a difficult type of questions. Keep always in mind that last minute. Keep always in mind that a minute lost, a student would have already utilized it and will be ahead of you. Eat healthy, avoid outside food, and stay away from communicable diseases. These things will trigger your exam preparation. Learn from previous mistakes and avoid them in future. After every weekly test, solve the paper with an open book and understand the principles behind each question. Optional. Buy magazines related to your exam preparation. This will give you an edge over the others. Be open-minded. Keep your mind open to new concepts and learn to accept facts. And don't argue with the facts, it will destroy your exam preparation. Use mobile wisely, stay away from laptop and mobile phones. Use them as positives for your preparation. Keep important presentations in your mobile or laptop and access them when you are free, like while traveling in the bus. How many MCQs should you solve? Solve MCQs only and only after you have understood the concepts thoroughly. Solve at least 100 MCQs a day, total of 300 for 3 subjects. Using this technique, you can easily get a government seat. In counseling, which college should I choose, government or private? Have a look at the previous counseling data, which is available to all online, and choose accordingly. Be in touch with seniors, they will help you. Top colleges data is always available online and you can check that out. Be religiously strong. Because in tough times, God is the only answer to our prayers. Sleep at least for 7 hours. Having irregular sleep will affect your marks. Meditate and do yoga. Count your footsteps while walking and pay attention to your breath. These techniques will increase your concentration power. Read motivation quotes daily. I recommend the book The Secret. Reading a quote in that book daily will brighten your neurons. Always have extracurricular activities so that it acts like a stress breaker or stress buster. Keep yourself involved in sports, music, or cooking. Share your problems with your family members and don't keep things trapped within yourself. It'll do more harm to yourself. Study the portions daily, be ahead of your teacher, finish the chapter, and in the class you must go with your doubts and clear it as soon as possible. Weekends must be the days where your revision of the entire week must be done. Maintain a formula sheet to keep the formula on your fingertips. Maintain a biological clock with respect to the exam timing. Watch motivational videos on YouTube frequently to keep yourself motivated. Make best use of e-learning. Do not bunk classes if the content is useful, and bunk classes if the content can be self-learned. In this way, you will be saving time. Goodbye from Dr. Hub, your e-doctor.